On this channel, I restore a lot of old photographs. Today, I'm going to show you how I use curves in Photoshop to restore a faded photograph from looking like this to looking like this. Let's get started. So the very first thing I'm going to do is give a short explanation of something called a histogram. Now, histograms are quite an advanced feature in visual editing and can potentially be quite complicated, so I'll only be touching on the most basic features of them here, as it's certainly not something which you have to use to fix a faded image. The reason I'm bringing it up at all is that I always want my tutorials to not only explain how to do something, but also to explain why we're doing it, as I think that added context is really key to learning a new skill. So with all that said, you can bring up the histogram in Photoshop by going up to Window and then clicking Histogram. Now, at the moment, the histogram is showing us a lot of quite advanced, quite complicated information, and for that reason, it's quite cluttered. So what we can do is go to this little drop-down menu here and choose to go to Expanded View. Now, under Channel at the moment, we can see the histogram was giving us the colour information for the picture, but all we want is the raw brightness values, so we can change colours to luminosity. And now, we have a much simpler histogram to look at. To demonstrate more clearly how the histogram works, I created some examples. So a histogram is designed to visualise the brightness values of the pixels in an image by giving us a bar graph of those values. So in this first example, I filled a large space with black, a medium-sized space with grey, and a small space with white. And on the histogram, we can see that we have three lines, one that's very tall, one that's medium-sized, and one that is small. And that directly reflects what we're seeing in the image. The left-hand bar indicates the large amount of black in the picture, the medium-sized bar indicates the amount of grey in the picture, and the small bar indicates the amount of white. The histogram goes from left to right, with the left-hand side representing the darkest values, and the right-hand side representing the lightest values. In example 2, I inverted the image, so the black left-hand side is now white, and the white right-hand side is now black. The histogram reflects this, because our smallest percentage is now the black, and it's still shown on the left-hand side. The grey is still shown in the centre, and our largest section is now white, and that is reflected by a large bar on the right-hand side. So these last two examples have obviously been rather manufactured. I'll now show you, with some pictures that I took, how the histogram works in practice with real photographs. So looking at this first example of a pear tree surrounded by flowers, the main thing to note is the histogram is far more complicated now that we have more shades of brightness within it. A histogram always looks at the image, at least when you've set it to luminosity, as if it were black and white. Therefore, the easiest way to see how the histogram is working is to temporarily convert our image to black and white. So looking at our histogram, we can see that the furthest left-hand side and the furthest right-hand side don't have very much information on them, whereas obviously our previous examples had high spikes here. Now this is perfectly normal. In the real world, you don't tend to come across very many areas that are absolute pure black or absolute pure white in terms of brightness. So in this example, we can see there are a few darker bars, and that likely represents these dark areas near the pear tree post. And also this sign is quite reflective, so we're getting some bright white spikes here. But for the most part, we're not getting anything too extreme. Our next example is a lot darker as an image, and therefore we have far less bright values on the right. In fact, most of our values when we go to black and white are at best lighter grey. Now, this example is interesting as we don't really have any histogram spikes in the centre, and that is because this is quite a high contrast image. So we have a lot of darker information and a lot of brighter information, but not very much information that is neither quite dark nor quite bright. Our final example here is some very grey clouds, and predictably, our histogram is values of grey, without really any high brights or dark darks. So the first thing to take away from all this, I think, is that every image has a different histogram. There is no such thing as an objectively correct histogram to which all images should look like. An image such as these clouds is going to have a very different histogram to this image of a bowl, and that's perfectly fine. The second thing to take away from this is that it's quite unusual, even in an image with quite bright and quite dark spots, to have pure whites and pure blacks in terms of your brightness values. But what if you wanted to have pure blacks and pure whites within your image? Well, that's what you can do with a curves adjustment. So if I switch this on quickly, we'll see that our histogram has been stretched out. This is afterwards, this is before. We have the same sort of peaks on the histogram, but they're now a lot wider. And what we've done is stretched our histogram out. And what was previously our sort of lighter grey clouds are now dazzling white, and what was previously slightly dark clouds are now black. Now, obviously this is an extreme example, but we will be using curves in much this same way to restore our faded image. So let's get back to it. So looking at our faded man's histogram, we can more clearly see the issue. So on the left-hand side, and on the right-hand side, we just don't have any information. This man has got some quite dark shadow areas on him, such as here next to his trousers, and also he's wearing a white shirt, but neither of those things are properly reflected by this histogram. All of our values are in the centre, and are grey, and that's just not correct for this image. By the way, if you've been seeing this little warning sign up in the corner, that's not something to worry about. All that represents is that this is a rough preview histogram and not the final adjusted histogram. But if we click this little sign, we can see that actually there's not much difference between the two. Every time you make any kind of change, the histogram will update and go into preview mode. So for the most part, you can just ignore this and leave it in preview mode, and as you've seen, it's really not any different. So to work with curves, you'll want to go down to here and click the Create New Fill or Adjustment Layer button and select to add a curves adjustment. Before we make any adjustments, you'll want to make sure this curves adjustment layer is in luminosity blend mode, so that we're only affecting the raw brightness values in the image and not the colour values as well. If you were working with a colour image and you wanted to affect the contrast of the colours, we can either use normal mode or colour mode here. But since I just want to work with the black and white, as it were, brightness values, I'm going to be working in luminosity mode. So with that done, this is the curves control panel. As you can see, it uses a histogram to show you which parts of the image's brightness you're editing. It also shows us, as the earlier histogram did, that the left and right hand sides are rather lacking in information. To start off, we can quite quickly get rid of these gaps on the left and right hand side by moving in our input black and our output white closer to the centre. We can do that by dragging in these two arrows here. So as you see, if you click and drag this white arrow closer to the centre and closer to our histogram, if you look at our top histogram, it's now been moved further to the right. We can do the same with our black arrow and drag that closer to our histogram, and that has also stretched it out. Now, we don't want to push this too far at the moment, and obviously we don't want to move in so we get absolute black or white, as we did with that earlier exaggerated cloud picture, but that is a good way of closing off the gaps. And if we switch our curves adjustment on and off here, we can see what a difference we've already made. Now, looking at our image, despite us having made quite a dramatic difference, our grey values in the centre of the image obviously also need some work. So we'll do that now. Now, you can just click and drag on your curves line to add points. But I find the best way to adjust the curves line is by using this little hand modify tool here. This tool allows you to drag directly on the image to adjust that selected level of contrast in the image. It's far easier to demonstrate this than to explain it. With the tool selected, when you hover over the image, you'll see you get this little bouncing dot on your curves histogram, and this indicates which part of the histogram you're currently hovering over. So if we hover over this dark point here next to his trousers, we can see we're on the left hand side of the histogram. And when we hover over his hand here that's a lot brighter, we can see we're on the right hand side of the histogram. This allows us to see exactly which part of the histogram we'll be altering, and then when we drag up or down on this point, we can see that's the part that we're brightening or darkening. So it's usually better to start in the centre of your histogram, I find, which in this case is represented at this spot near the man's elbow. Now, looking at the suit, we can see it's a bit too bright. So if we click and drag at this point, we can darken it down. Conversely, looking at the image, we can see that the background is a bit darker than we might like. So we can drag up on that point to brighten it up. Now, looking at his beard, I feel that the darker points need to be darker, and the lighter parts might need to be a little bit lighter. So we can drag down on the darker points, and if we want to, drag up just a little on the lighter points. You can edit these points at any time in curves by hovering over your chosen point until you see this little movement arrows icon, and then you can drag it around to change the values. You can add as many points as you want to this line. It's very much down to personal preference and what adjustments your particular photograph needs. One important thing to remember is you don't want to drag your points too far. So if, for example, I were to drag up this shadow information here, you can see that eventually you can make your shadows white, and obviously you don't want to do that. Generally speaking, the best way to learn curves is just to experiment with it. In terms of experimenting, however, trying to undo an adjustment initially in curves isn't quite as straightforward as it could be. Control, or if you're on a Mac, Command Z may only undo one level of error, and pressing it again may bring that error back in again, such as this. If, however, you add an Alt in with your Control or Command Z, you will instead take steps backwards in your process rather than doing a simple undo. So now, if we keep pressing that, you'll see it's removing our changes one by one. If all else fails, you can use this drop-down box in your curves adjustment to reset your curves. Now, if we press that once, we'll see that all it's got rid of is our smaller adjustments. If we press that again, we'll see it completely resets curves. Now, this two-stage adjustments to your curves is really useful if you want to make changes to the way that you've added points to the curves line without obviously having to redo this input-output stage again. So that's basically curves. One final thing to mention is that if you lose your curves window at any point, or it's closed unexpectedly like that, you can double-click on your little curves icon here to bring it back. Outside of the issue with the fading in this picture, you'll notice it has some small spots of damage. If you'd like to watch some tutorials on how to fix damage such as this, or how to add colour to images like this, those are available on my channel. Along with tutorials, my channel has a large variety of videos which showcase old photographs such as one where I coloured every pre-colour photography US president. As always, any thoughts, questions, or suggestions for future videos are always appreciated in the comments below. Thanks for watching.